Great. I'm glad you made it. That will get find a little balance while we're here today, for sure. That's the biggest thing. Okay, great. Yes, thank you. So it's just a minute or two off.
Start by And make sure your weight is even across the front and back of the body, so don't lean too far forward onto the ankles. If you'd like to deepen your stretch, you can brace the palms on the floor, press the hands into the floor, and then curve around the spine, like you're trying to press the center of your spine back behind you. Squeeze in. option is to always, you can always bring the hands to the floor if this becomes too intense. And here we're looking for a postural correction first. So lengthening through the crown of the head, shoulders down and back, arch your lower back and press that right hip especially down into the floor. I want you to feel the stretch begin in that side. And then when you're ready, you can wrap the left hand or the left arm around the right knee. So opposite arm to knee wraps around good. And we're looking out over the back shoulder and then allowing our shoulders to follow. Opposite arm to knee. So if your right knee is up, your left arm wraps around. Opposite arm to knee. And then we're looking out and sitting up tall. So that spinal extension is what's going to really help you to get that good stretch through the glute med and abductors of the thigh. That's what we're looking for it. And keep in mind too, you will get further into that twist if you cave in the spine and over your shoulder, but then we lose our form. So we want to keep it nice and straight and tall, even if that knee's not going quite as far. One more deep breath in. Exhale, look forward, square the shoulders forward, and we'll extend the legs. Full snap to reset, and this time you can come into the standard staff pose, or you can come with me and clasp the hands behind you for the yoga mudra, or you can grasp the wrists or forearms, or place the fingertips on the floor behind you. Take a deep breath in and extend. Exhale, press everything down toward the floor, knuckles, elbows, shoulders. Now let's inhale and lift the arms up and away from the body. Exhale and tip from the head, relaxing down over the legs. Press the backs of the knees down to the floor. Breathe deeply. And now we'll look forward to come up with a straight spine. Elbows bend and we reach in front, curving around the upper back. And release, and now we'll come to the other side, bringing that left foot to the inside of the right calf or thigh. Sitting up tall, shoulders square forward toward the extended leg. And we inhale first. And then exhale and tip from the hip. Relaxing down over the legs. Left fingertips can crawl forward toward the instep of the right foot if you like. As you inhale, think of widening the back. As you exhale, notice where you can relax.
Away from the body, exhale, relax down. Good.
arm curve around the upper back. And release, excellent. Now we'll come into a little deer series. So rocking back onto our hands, we're gonna bend the knees so they point up toward the sky. Just make sure those shoulders stay down and back. No matter what we're doing, we're gonna just drop the knees to the right side. So both knees pointed to the right here. And then from here, we're just gonna press up, noticing the flexibility of that hip. We'd like the sole of the right foot against the left thigh. If that's not comfortable for you, the left knee can rest on the right foot. And we're sitting up tall to start, shoulders down and back, take a deep breath in. Exhale and drop your left shoulder down toward the left hip. Now here we're just noticing the flexibility of the knee and hip on that side. You can look up toward the sky if you like, that's gonna keep your shoulders and hips properly stacked here. And we're just breathing into it, relaxing wherever you can. So you'll notice that this leg will probably tense up when we lean on it, which is good, because that's gonna protect the joints, but we wanna notice if it's safe for us to relax here. And now we'll come up and turn our shoulders toward the left leg. Place the left hand on the sole of the left foot. Right hand comes to the left knee. So both hands are on that same leg. Inhale, extend the spine. Square the shoulders with that shin as much as you're able. And then relax down over the leg. Tuck your elbows in toward the body. Relax. Good. Yeah, really good. And again, we're just checking in if this is too much of a twist for your knee or hip. You can always straighten that left leg out anytime and come to the staff modification instead. And now let's sit up. Square the shoulders forward. Left hand comes to the right knee. So again, opposite hand to knee. We're going to reach out with that free arm. Breathe in deep. Straighten up first. And then exhale and bend. So now you can let your weight shift onto that left leg a little bit to stretch out the hip and thigh if that's comfortable for you. If it's not comfortable, come back into the half staff with the side bend anytime. Lengthen through the fingertips, breathe deeply. Expand the rib cage as you inhale and relax as you exhale. Right leg, bringing the right. step the right foot forward for a low lunge. Press the hips toward the floor, and one or both elbows can come to the front thigh. We're tucking the tailbone, lacing up the core, and feeling that good stretch through the hip flexor. Check your shoulders are down and back. Neck is long, and we're breathing deeply. Now, if you'd like, you can curl the back toe under and lift the back knee up off the floor. Relaxing your hips down toward the earth. Good. Whatever position you're in, we just want to feel that stretch through the hip flexor. Breathe. And now let's bring that back knee back down to the floor and the hands down to the inside of the front foot. Readjust as necessary to make that front hip and knee comfortable. And we'll bring that hand on the front leg side to the knee. Look up toward the sky and allow your shoulders to follow. So as much as this is a twist for the spine, I'd like you to really focus this extension through your lower body. So when we twist, we're coming into a pelvic twist as well. It should increase the intensity of the stretch in the insides of the thighs and the front of that back hip as well. If you'd like more from this pose, you can curl the back toe under and lift the knee. You can reach that right arm up toward the sky. You can wrap the arm back behind the body. Just make it yours. So you can wrap the arm behind the body with the back knee on the floor. It's all up to you. Any combination of those movements, as long as your form is perfect and everything feels comfortable. Good, yeah? Now let's inhale and reach up toward the sky. Exhale, both hands to the inside of the front foot, and that back knee can come back down. Here comes our adductor stretch. Shifting to the back knee. Turn them to the side, and we'll shift forward. Great. So feeling that extension from the inside of the knee up into the adductors, up to the inside of the thigh. You can rock from side to side here. I want you to think about doing a push-up. So just let your upper body support the weight of your lower body as you shift around. And if you'd like, you can walk the hands forward, gently bending the elbows in toward the body. Relaxing down toward the floor. Noticing how your front knee feels. So we're doing a lot of twisting today, and you can always realign that front foot on the straight plane if that's what's best for your joints. Just take another breath or two here. Relax wherever you're able. And now we'll bring the hands back under the shoulders, shift to the back knee, recenter the front foot, and we'll step forward into forward fold. Relax down over the legs. Shift the weight into the heels and lift your tailbone up toward the sky. Relax the arms and neck. And now let's step the right leg back, top of the back foot and back knee come to the floor, and the elbows can come to the front thigh when you feel ready. We'd like our shoulders to be level with the floor, neck is long. Good. Let your hips sink down toward the floor. So I want you to notice that when you're exercising and also when you're doing yoga, what muscles are contracting, what muscles are relaxing, and how can we control that better? In this pose, I ask you to bring your elbows to the thigh so that we have our body at the same angle as our leg, which makes our lower back nice and neutral rather than the hyperextension. So just be aware that you feel comfortable in whatever position you're in. If you'd like a little more here, you can curl the back toe under and lift the back knee up off the floor. Press into your back heel. See if you can find an extension through the lower leg as well. Relax your hips down toward the floor. Breathe. One more deep breath in. Exhale, and we'll bring that back knee down to the floor. Hands come down to the inside of the front foot. You can readjust your pillar foot to accommodate the hip and knee if you need to. Just being mindful of how that feels. And then we'll bring the hand on the front leg side to that knee. Shoulders down and back. We extend and inhale first, and then exhale. bend of the shoulders, shift to the back knee, crease the front foot, we're going to curl the back toe under, and step back into downward dog. You can step back into child's pose, or come into a forward fold, if that's best for you. And we're just gently pressing those heels for the floor one at a time. Or rolling around on the balls of the feet. Check your shoulders, you're down away from the ears, and now I'd like you to spread your fingers and press the hands into the mat. You grip the mat. Feel your stability here. And breathe.
Great. Inhale, reach the arms up to align with the ears. Sink
the center. So I just like it. This is called grounding. When we feel the soles of our feet, feel ourselves supported by the earth, feel our stability here. And then we do the centering part, center ourselves by bringing that focus inward, feeling our height, feeling our openness, and those relaxed arms here. Now let's inhale the arms out to the sides and overhead. Exhale and fold forward. Relax down on the legs. Good, just forward fold. And then we'll walk the hands out into downward dog. Press the heels toward the floor one at a time. Or roll around on the balls of the feet. Breathe deeply. Notice where you can relax. Now let's center the left foot between the hips. Then we'll draw the right leg forward, bringing the knee up between the hands and the front shin across the front of the body. And we're supporting our body weight with our hands until we're sure of the flexibility of our lower joints. And then we can slide into that back leg. The hands, or you can come down to the elbows on the floor. The upper body is supporting the weight of our body so that we can control the depth of our stretch. And when you feel ready, if you're comfortable and feel safe through the joints, you can extend the arms out all the way, relaxing down toward the floor. And we breathe. Back under the shoulders, curl the back toe under, lift the hips toward the sky, and set back into downward dog. Press the heels toward the floor one at a time. Remember that you can bring the knees to the floor anytime. Great. Now let's center the right foot between the hips, and we'll sweep that left leg forward, bringing the knee up between the hands and settling down to our pigeon on the other side. So if you have trouble getting there in one movement from the downward dog, you can come down into a table pose, lowering the knee, and then slide one leg forward and the other leg back and angle your front shin however you need to, as long as it's okay for those lower joints. Good, and then you can relax down into the pose a little further. And just keeping in mind that we are bringing the weight of our body down onto that knee and hip, so right onto those joints. So we want to be mindful that they always feel safe and comfortable here. Good. You can rock from side to side if you want to. You can extend the arms out all the way if you'd like. Widen the back as you inhale. Relax down as you exhale.
Deep breath in, exhale the knees back to center and we'll hug them into the chest.
reach out to the sides, relax the shoulders down, take a deep breath in. Exhale and drop the knees to the left side, coming out over the right fingertips. Press your shoulders right down into the floor, move slowly and suck your belly back toward the spine as you move to protect your lower back. Good. Relax wherever you're able, let that deep twist come right to the shoulder blades in the upper back. Breathing deeply always. One more deep breath in. Exhale the knees back to neutral and we'll hug the knees into the chest and we'll finish with our full body stretch. Breathe in deep, reach out through the fingertips and toes, extending, take up lots of space. Exhale, bring everything into the center, knees to chest, forehead toward the knees. And again, breathe in deep, reach out, lengthen, expanding. Exhale, bring everything in, curve it around, squeeze the air to the body. One more time, breathe in deep, reach out, expand. Exhale, bring everything in, curve around. And release the body from the floor, and we'll come into our final relaxation. So I'll ask you to find your socks or sweaters or blankets, whatever you need to be warm and comfortable, now that we'll be slowing down and no longer moving. And we'll begin by just bringing the attention to our breathing, taking a deep breath in all the way down to the tips of the toes, stirring up any tension that might still be left there. And exhaling it out, pressing it out of the body with focus and consciousness. And then just for a moment, let's bring our attention to this class. Once again, give ourselves that mental pat on the back for making it here, for making it through, and especially for maintaining the lines of communication with the body. And now we'll begin to relax from the bottom up. Breathe in all the way down to the balls of the feet, the arches, heels, and ankles, stirring up tension. Exhale it out, pressing it out of the body with focus. Breathe through the calves, shins, knee joints, and thighs. Exhale tension all the way down to the breathe through the hips, pelvis, buttocks, and lower spine. Exhale tension, allowing them to relax down into the mat, to the earth. Breathe through the muscles of the lower back, side body, and abdomen. As you exhale, feel the internal organs relax, letting go of tension. Breathe through the middle and upper back, through the ribcage and solar plexus. As you exhale, allow heart and lungs to let go of tension. Relax the muscles in the neck, through the top of the spine and the base of the skull. Relax the throat. Relax the jaw. Relax the muscles of the face, around the eyes, mouth, and ears. Relax the brow. And lastly, release the breath, breathing naturally as you sink deeper into relaxation. space with you. Breathe into that feeling of gratitude to feel it fill the inside of your body, relaxing as you exhale. And then in that same manner, bring your attention to yourself and offer yourself that gratitude. Exhale and open.